Hello students, my name is G. Nikita, M. Pharmacy, Assistant Professor, Department of Pharmaceutical Chemistry. I will deal the inorganic chemistry. Subject name is Pharmaceutical Inorganic Chemistry for Pharmacy first year. So today we are going to discuss about acid-base titrations. So the topic name is acid-base titrations. So in this we will discuss the introduction, means what is the acid-base titrations and what is the alkalimetry and acidimetry acid-base indicators. So introduction, alkalimetry and acidimetry acid-base indicators. So in this topic we are going to discuss what means what is the acid-base titration and what is the alkalimetry and acidimetry and what is the acid-base indicators and what are the indicators we are going to use in the acid-base titration. So in this topic we are going to discuss that what is the acid-base titration and what is the alkalimetry and acidimetry and what is the acid-base indicators and what are the indicators we are going to use in acid-base titrations. So let's see the introduction, means what is the acid-base titration. So acid-base titration is a procedure used in quantitative chemical analysis to determine the concentration of either acid or the base by neutralizing it with a standard solution of base or acid having known concentration. And indicator is used to monitor the process of acid-base reaction. See, I will repeat it again. Acid-base titration is a process, is a procedure used in quantitative chemical analysis to determine the concentration of acid or a base by neutralizing it with a standard solution of base or an acid having known concentration. And indicator is used to monitor the progress of the acid-base reaction. Here, the acid-base titration is nothing but we will use this process to know the concentration of unknown concentration of acid or the base by using the known concentration of the acid or the base. For example, if we want to know the concentration of the acid, so we can able to know the concentration of the acid by using the known concentration of the base. So if we want to know the concentration of the base, means we can able to find the concentration of the base by using the known concentration of the acid. See here, for example, if we want to know the concentration of the base. So if we want to know the concentration of the base, means here in the conical flask we have to take the base, that is the unknown concentration. In the base we have to take the unknown concentration is base. In here in the burette we have to take the known concentration is acid. So in conical flask we have to take the base and here we have to take the acid, and by using we have to add the 2 or 3 drops of the indicator. And if whatever the base present in the conical flask is titrated by using the acid, no, at that time we will get the result. So we can able to find the concentration of the base. So if you want to know the concentration of the acid, means so we don't know the concentration of the acid. So unknown concentration of the acid we have to take in the conical flask, and known concentration of the base we have to take in the burette. So 2 or 3 drops of suitable indicator we have to add. When the base is when the acid, whatever the acid present in the conical flask is titrated by using the known concentration of the base, means we will get the result and we can able to know the concentration of the acid. Here acid base titration is to know the concentration, to know the unknown concentration of the acid or the base by using the known concentration of the base or acid. Here we are using the indicator to continue the reaction and to get the result. So this is the meaning of the acid base titration, means nothing but to determine the concentration of the acid or base by using the base or acid, which is known concentration, and indicator is used to progress the acid-base reaction. So let's discuss what is the alkalimetry and acidimetry reaction. So this both will play an important role. So what are their alkalimetry and acidimetry plays an important role in the acid-base titration for the neutralization reaction. See, when the acid and the base will be mixed at the equal proportion, means the solution will get neutralized. So the fundamental reaction is neutralization reaction. So the acid base reaction is also known as neutralization reaction. So what is the acidimetry? Means the acidimetry is mainly used to determine the concentration of the base, basic substances. So it is used to know the concentration of the base substances by using the standard acid. So see here, if you want to know the concentration of the base, means what is the acidimetry? Means to know the concentration of the base. So to know the concentration of the base, here we have to take the base in the conical flask. So in the conical flask we have to take the base, that is the unknown concentration, and in the burette we have to take the acid, that is the known concentration. So we have to add the suitable indicator for it. So when this unknown concentration of the base is titrated with known concentration of the acid which is present in the burette, the color will be changes, then we get the result. So that result is known as the concentration of the base. See here, in acidimetry the known volume of the base should be taken in the conical flask. I said now that the base should be taken in the conical flask and the acid should be taken in the burette. So the base is put in the conical flask and this solution is titrated against the standard solution of the acid taken in the burette till the equivalent point of the acid is added to the base. So equivalent point is nothing but when the both the acid and the base will be mixed, no? So at what point we are going to get the result, that point is known as the equivalent point. So the point where we are going to get the result is known as equivalent point. So if the both acids and bases are strong, so both acid and bases are strong, means we will get the pH is 7. So if acid or the base, or both of the acid and the base are weak, so we won't get the pH is 7. So acidimetry is nothing but it is used to know the concentration of the basic substances by using the acid. So how means? We have to take the unknown concentration of the acid in conical flask. So we have to take the acid in the conical flask and known concentration of the base in the burette. We have to add the suitable indicator to the conical flask, here in the conical flask. So when this acid present in the conical flask, see here, the acid present in the conical flask is titrated with the base present in the burette, then we will get the result. So we can able to find the concentration of the base. So if the both acid and base are strong in nature, means we will get the pH is 7. So if both the acid and the base, or any of the acid or base is weak, means we won't get the pH 7. So that is about the meaning of acidimetry. So what is the meaning of alkalimetry? Means it is used to determine the concentration of the acid substances by using the standard base. So in alkalimetry is used to know the concentration of the acid by using the base. See here, for the alkalimetry we are going to find out the concentration of the acid. So the unknown concentration of the acid should be taken in the conical flask. The known concentration of the base should be taken here in the burette. So we have to add the suitable indicator. So this acid should be titrated. Whatever the acid present in the conical flask should be titrated by using the base, whatever the base present in the burette. And if the both acid and the bases are strong, means we will get the pH is 7. So if of any of the acid or the base, both acid or the bases are weak, means we won't get the pH is 7. See, I will explain it again, what is the acidimetry and what is the alkalimetry. So acidimetry is mainly used to determine the concentration of the base. So acidimetry means you used to know the concentration of the base. So the always the unknown concentration of the sample should be taken in the conical flask. So this is the conical flask. Always unknown concentration should of the sample should be taken here. So the unknown concentration of the base should be taken here, and the known concentration of the acid should be taken in the burette. So if the base is titrated by using the acid present in the burette, means we will get the result. So by that result we can able to know the concentration of the base. So acidimetry means to know the concentration of the base. So the base should be taken in the conical flask and acid should be taken in the burette. So when the whatever the base present in the conical flask is titrated by using the acid present in the burette, means we will get the result. So we can able to find out the concentration of the base. So in case of the alkalimetry, it is used to determine the concentration of the acid. So the unknown concentration of the acid should be taken here in the conical flask. The unknown concentration of the acid should be taken in the conical flask, and known concentration of the base should be taken in the burette. So this acid, if the acid is titrated by using this base, means we will get the result. Then we can able to find out the concentration of the acid. So acidimetry means used to know the concentration of the base. Alkalimetry means used to know the concentration of the acid. Always remember one thing, that when we are going to perform any experiment in the acid-base titration, not only in acid-based titration, in any type of the titration, remember one thing, always we have to take the unknown concentration, means for what solution we are going to find the concentration, means for that unknown concentration of the solution should be taken in the conical flask, and known concentration of the solution should be taken in the burette. So here, in the conical flask, unknown concentration. In the burette, known concentration of the solution should be taken. So in the acidimetry means we are going to find out the concentration of the base. So we don't know the concentration of the base in acidimetry. So we have to take the base in the conical flask. We know the concentration of the acid. So we have to take in the burette. But for the alkalimetry, we don't know the concentration of the acid. Means we have to find out the concentration of the acid. So we have to take the acid in the conical flask and the base in the burette. So this is about the alkalimetry and acidimetry. Next one is acid-base indicator. So these are mainly used to get the equivalent point. So the indicators have one color in a acid solution and another color in the basic solution. So this acid-base indicators is mainly used to get the equivalent point. Means it is mainly used to get the result. And this indicators when we use in the acidic solution means we will get one color. When this indicator is used in the basic solution means we will get another color. Let's see what are the indicators we are going to use. First one is phenolphthalein, litmus, methyl red and methyl orange. You see here phenolphthalein, litmus, methyl red and methyl orange. Next one, what is the pH range of the phenolphthalein? 8.3 to 10.5. It color in acid is colorless, color in base is red. Next one is litmus. The pH of the litmus is 5.5 to 7.4 and color in the red acid is red, color in the base is red. Next, methyl red. The pH range of the methyl red is 4.5 to 6.5. Color in acid is red. Color in base is yellow. Next, methyl orange. The pH range of the methyl orange is 3.2 to 4.5. And color in acid is pink. Color in base is yellow. See, I will explain it again. The phenolphthalein indicator name is phenolphthalein. The pH range of the phenolphthalein is 8.3 to 10.5. The color in acid is colorless. Color in base is red. Next, litmus. The pH range of the litmus is 5.5 to 7.4. Color in acid is red. Color in base is red. Next, methyl red. The pH range of the methyl red is 4.5 to 6.5. Color in acid is red. Color in base is yellow. Next, methylene orange. The pH range of the methylene orange is 3.2 to 4.5. And color in acid is pink. Color in base is yellow. Next, the choice of indicators in various acid-base titration. See what are the indicators that we are going to use for the strong acid and strong base. Strong acid is hydrochloric acid and sulfuric acid. And strong base is sodium hydroxide and potassium hydroxide. So, indicators are methyl orange or phenolphthalein. So if we use the methyl orange, the solution will change from red color to yellow color. So if we use the phenolphthalein as the indicator, the solution changes colorless to pink color. Next, strong acid and with weak base. Strong acid example, the sulfuric acid, and weak base example, ammonium hydroxide. The indicators are methyl orange or methyl red. So if we use the methyl orange as the indicator, the solution changes from red to yellow. If we use the methyl red as the indicator, the solution changes from red to yellow. Next, weak acid and strong base. So weak acid is the acetic acid, strong base is the sodium hydroxide. The indicator is the phenolphthalein. The solution changes from colorless to pink. Next one is weak acid and weak base. Weak acid is the acetic acid. weak base is the ammonium hydroxide. So if you use the weak acid and the weak base for the titration, means there is no suitable indicator for it. So we cannot able to do the experiment by using the weak acid and weak base. See, I will explain it again. Strong acid and strong base. Strong acid is hydrochloric acid and sulfuric acid. Strong base is sodium hydroxide and potassium hydroxide. The indicator is methyl orange or phenolphthalein. So methyl, if we use the methyl orange as the indicator, the solution changes from red to yellow. If we use the phenolphthalein as the indicator, the solution changes from colorless to pink. Next, strong acid and weak base. Strong acid is the sulfuric acid. Weak base is the ammonium hydroxide. Indicators are methyl orange or methyl red. If we use the methyl orange as the indicator, the solution changes from red color to yellow color. If we use the methyl red as the indicator, the solution changes from red color to yellow color. Next, weak acid and strong base. Weak acid is the acetic acid. Strong base is the sodium hydroxide. Phenolphthalein is the indicator. So the solution changes from colorless to pink color. Next, weak acid and the weak base. So weak acid is the acetic acid. Weak base is the ammonium hydroxide. Here, there is no suitable indicator when we perform the experiment by using the weak acid and the weak base. So we cannot able to find out the suitable indicator. That's why we cannot able to perform the experiment by using the weak acid or weak base. So in this, what we have discussed in acid base titration topic, so we have discussed that what is the acid base titration means, what is the definition of the acid base titration, and what is the alkalimetry and acidimetry, and what is the acid base indicators, and what are the indicators we have used in the acid base titration. See, what is the acid base titration? It is used to know the concentration of the acid or the base by using the known concentration of the base or the acid by using the indicator. So what is the alkalimetry? It is used to know the concentration of the base by using the known concentration of the acid. So in the conical flask, always we should take the unknown concentration of the solution. So in the alkalimetry, we don't know the concentration of the acid. So we have to take the acid in the conical flask, and known concentration of the base should be taken in the burette. In the acidimetry, it is used to know the concentration of the base. So here we don't know the concentration of the base, so we have to take the base in the conical flask, and acid is the known concentration, so we have to take the acid in the burette. So what is the acid base indicators? Means these indicators are mainly used to know the equivalent point. So it is mainly used to know at what point we are going to get the result. So we are using the various types of indicators like phenolphthalein, methyl red, methyl orange indicators. So these are the references book should be followed for the acid base titrations topic. Thank you.